morning, voters. It's not even been a week since Modi government 2.0 took charge. But already it seems the government is testing the waters on what has been on its things to do list for quite some time now. Times Network has learned from its sources that the government is mulling fresh delimitation for Jammu and Kashmir. Now, while this will be a long process and elaborate exercise if and when it happens, it has already triggered a big debate tonight. Delimitation, viewers, is the process carried out to redefine the boundaries of our constituencies, assembly constituencies, Lok Sabha constituencies, as per the changing population, as per the changing demographics. We last had this big exercise done in India in 2008. But Jammu and Kashmir wasn't part of it. Five other states were not part of it. Jammu and Kashmir specifically hasn't had delimitation exercise carried out since 1995. In fact, in 2002, Farooq Abdullah government put a 24-year freeze on it. They changed the rule, they changed the law, and they said until 2026, no delimitation, no changing of territorial boundaries can happen for the constituencies of Jammu and Kashmir. This was actually then upheld by the Supreme Court. Effectively, even if a proportion of various communities, various castes and communities in a region changes, even if the proportion of the population of various regions in a state changes between Jammu and Kashmir and Ladakh, they will still continue to be represented by the same number of MLAs, by the same number of seats in the assembly. Right now, Kashmir is represented by 46 seats and Jammu is represented by 37 seats. So let us understand, why was this freeze put on the delimitation exercise in the first place? And if the situation changes now, what does it really mean? Tonight we ask, is it time to redraw Jammu and Kashmir constituency maps? If we do that, will Jammu get a higher representation, a higher number of seats in the assembly? Will the government's plan clear the legal hurdle? Because remember, even if the governor has the power, at the end of the day, the Supreme Court nodded off on the 2002 decision. So can we clear that legal hurdle? And will delimitation effectively change the politics of Jammu and Kashmir? Those are the questions. But first up, here's a report from Nikunj on the story.
Irrespective of the fact that whether central government gets involved in this entire fresh initiative of a new delimitation commission for the state of Jammu and Kashmir, which has been stuck in an imbroglio for quite some time now, and according to many, many neutral observers, this position has been patently unfair to the people of the regions of Jammu and Ladakh. The tacit backing from the central government to any such move by the governor of J&K, in whom, according to the constitutional provisions, these powers are vested for setting up of a new delimitation commission, would always be there. And once the governor Satyapal Malik decides to, after he has the due deliberations and consultations at his own level with almost all the stakeholders in the state of Jammu and Kashmir, once he decides to start the process or a fresh initiative of a new delimitation commission, the central government is absolutely clear that it will definitely provide all kinds of backing that the chief governor's initiative would require, in the sense of going to the Supreme Court and getting the pending stay vacated from the Supreme Court, which had earlier concurred with the view of the state government of J&K that the delimitation process should be postponed till about a certain year and date. And from there on, because of the security implications and because of the fact that Pakistan certainly would not allow any such exercise to go unhindered, the security requirements of the state of Jammu and Kashmir would also be fulfilled by the Ministry of Home Affairs, Government of India. So in that sense, once the governor decides to go ahead with this entire process of a fresh delimitation commission and notify the report of the delimitation, he would certainly have a comprehensive 360-degree backing from the Ministry of Home Affairs and the Government of India. It's just that the governor will have to fulfill the deliberation process and bell the cat finally to break this imbroglio, which is obviously, many would say, fulfill the aspiration of a very large segment of the population of the state of Jammu and Kashmir.
Before we go to the debate, here's some more breaking news coming in. The Election Commission has now confirmed that the assembly polls will be held later this year in Jammu and Kashmir. Remember, while the general elections were held in the state, the assembly polls are not held along with it last month. And now the Election Commission is saying they do intend to hold elections later this year, sometime in the last quarter perhaps. We don't know. The Election Commission has also said that they are monitoring the situation in Jammu and Kashmir regularly on a real-time basis, and then depending on the situation, on the current tension, on the amount of militancy activity, perhaps the EC will take a decision. EC has also said that the schedule of assembly polls will most probably be decided after the Amarnath Yatra concludes. So let's get back to the debate and say good evening to our panelists. Rajiv Pandey, leader of the BJP, joins us this evening. Vikas Singh, former ASG. Rahul Jalali, senior journalist. Dr. Harbaksh Singh, spokesperson of the PDP. Dr. Sameer Kaul, spokesperson with the National Conference. And consulting editor of Times Network, Vinay Tiwari, with us in our Mumbai studios. Let me go across to Vinay first. Vinay, just to help us understand and put it in perspective, because delimitation itself is a very technical word, and you know, but how often does India do it, and what really then is the impact?
Well, two things, Tanvi. The Constitution provides for a delimitation every 10 years, and that's what perhaps is followed in most of the other states, which has not happened in Jammu and Kashmir. You said in the intro rightly, the last one was done in 1995, and ironically, it was done at a time when the state was again under president's rule. Jagmohan was then the governor, and via him, this was done in 1995, and it hasn't happened since then. And which is why there has been a constant demand. In fact, the BJP has been very consistent in the demand. I remember in 2008 as well, this demand was raised by the BJP in the assembly where they wanted a delimitation exercise to be done, because their long-standing demand, and some would argue rightly so, has been that the Jammu region, despite being more in population as well as geographically being the larger area, is underrepresented in the assembly. And remember, the delimitation rules or the constituency size rules are linked to the size and the population that you have. While that is one. The other thing which is important is the constitution also says that the number of the reserved seats need to be rotated as per the changing demography of a particular state, and that has also not happened in Jammu and Kashmir especially. So it's a bit of a legacy issue. It's always been a bit of a logjam. Two governments have tried it. The Farooq Abdullah government put a freeze on it. The Ghulam Nabi Azad government attempted it. But then the bottom line being that Jammu definitely remains underrepresented currently, even though it has, according to the 2011 census, a higher population ratio than, say, the valley. So clearly, this move that, even if the Home Ministry is not officially confirming it, but the fact that there is some talk about this now in Delhi means that this is the first big initiative on the Kashmir policy, which was perhaps widely expected since Mr. Amit Shah took over as the Home Minister of India, Tanvi.
Okay, so it falls in line with that expectation. And like Nikunj, our senior news editor, was also, you know, trying to tell us that, well, the movement has to come from the governor. The state is under president's rule. The governor has to take that call. And if and when the governor does take that call and initiates the process, firstly, they have to go to the Supreme Court and get clearance from the Supreme Court, because there is a verdict that the Supreme Court gave in 2010. And then if all of this is done, the government, the center, Nikunj said, will fully back this decision. So that's what he was trying to explain to us. Mr. Rahul Jalali, good evening to you. Our first question, of course, on this debate is it time to redefine the boundaries, the constituency boundaries in Jammu and Kashmir? What's your view?
Well, I think it's a ticklish problem for the government. I mean, when they go in for a delimitation, because the fact of the matter is that a large number of people in Kashmir are not going to be happy about it. And this unhappiness, what form does it take, is anyone's guess. Kashmir has been relatively quiet for a long period. So whether you would like to provoke it is a question that remains to be looked at, and looked at carefully. Secondly, delimitation, the supposition is that delimitation is going to give a larger number of seats to Jammu. Because the last census did decide that Jammu has a greater population than Kashmir. But then Kashmir has been clamoring that there was something wrong with the census, but they have more. But whatever the case might be, Jammu does get a greater share, which will again fuel the separatist elements in Kashmir, if that tends to happen. So these are issues which need to be looked into. Limitation, that the delimitation has never been done for this long, just goes to show how provocative this exercise is going to be in the state. So if they're going to go for a delimitation, the current government, they have to really give it a very, very serious thought before they venture into it. I would suggest that they better be very serious about going in for a delimitation commission.
Well, there is no denying that it's going to be a challenging task if the government does decide to go ahead with this. Before I go to our political representatives, I just want to bring in a legal mind as well. Mr. Vikas Singh, former ASG, thank you for joining us. Obviously, because there was a Supreme Court verdict, do we then assume that the governor will first have to go to the Supreme Court and say, we don't want to wait till 2026, that we want the delimitation process to be done before that?
Well, I'll have to tell you a little bit of history on this delimitation freezing order. The first time the delimitation process was frozen was in 1976 in the 42nd Amendment to the Constitution, which was all India. And the purpose was that you should not have any delimitation till 2000 because they wanted the family planning initiative of the government to succeed. Then 2001 was the next census which happened, and 2002 was the delimitation which actually happened all over the country. And because of that 2002 delimitation, again, constituencies were rearranged. 2002, when the NDA was in power, Mr. Arun Jaitley was the law minister. It is at that time that the 84th amendment to the Constitution took place. And in that 84th amendment, this 2026 came in. They said that till 2026, there should be the delimitation that takes place after 2026 should only be the basis for any further delimitation in the country. And Jammu and Kashmir merely followed this same thing which was done at the center. Because normally, if this kind of an exercise is done for the country, then Jammu and Kashmir follows that. Now, as far as the rest of the country is concerned, this freezing order continues till 2026, so the next delimitation that will happen only after 2031. That is when the next census after 2021. 2021 will be the next, and the next after that will be 31. So the delimitation can only take place after 31. So I don't see any justification if the reason for delimitation freezing has been done by a constitutional amendment to the Indian Constitution and which has been done pari materia to the Jammu and Kashmir Constitution, then I don't see any justification to, you know, dealing the two today and try to, you know, rush up the process. Because if it was not justified for Jammu and Kashmir to follow the Government of India model of freezing the delimitation exercise till the next census comes in, till 31, then and if that is continuing, then what is the basis for you to say suddenly that we want to do it separately for Jammu and Kashmir? I also feel that in 2002, when Farooq Abdullah adopted the 84th amendment to the constitution and also amended his constitution, then obviously the Government of India had no grievance. That why are you doing it for Jammu and Kashmir? So they also felt that Jammu and Kashmir was pari materia with the rest of the country. So suddenly to start this exercise now only for Jammu and Kashmir and to let the rest of the country remain frozen till 2031 may not be something which may pass the legal test.
Mr. Singh,
because I'll tell you, even the power of the governor, is only to...
Yes, sorry.
Just one line only. The power of the governor to amend the law is also only for a period of 2 years. And you can't, if your power to amend the law is only for a period of 2 years, you can't, you know, do something which will have a impact beyond 2 years by this amending power. So that again will be a legal problem as far as the, unless if they, of course, assembly had met and the assembly had decided to amend the JK, Jammu and Kashmir Representation of People's Act and delete that proviso which was inserted in 2002, that would have been different. But I don't see that the governor will be, fully justified to do this kind of a thing.
Okay, so this is an interesting point that you raised.
At the time when the House is,
So this is an interesting point that you raised, that the governor can only do it for a period of 2 years. After that, it will need the backing of the assembly itself. But Mr. Singh, I'm a little confused here, because we do know there were some delimiting, exercises that were done in 2008. For the rest of India. In fact, some very interesting constituencies came up at that point of time, including... So I just wanted you to explain that. How was that done if it wasn't allowed?
I'll explain that. Yeah, I'll tell you how it was done. So what had happened was that after the freezing from 76 to 2000, there was a gap of 2000 to 2002 when there was no freezing of the delimitation. So the census happened in 2001, and the Delimitation Commission was Justice Kuldeep Singh was the head of that commission. So he actually went into that delimitation exercise in 2002. Now, when that 2002 delimitation exercise had already been done, and when the second freezing order came in 2002, which was to go on to 2026, somebody moved a petition in the Supreme Court and said that this delimitation has already taken place between 2000 and 2002 when there was no freezing order. So you must implement that. So 2008, the Supreme Court said that yes, if there has been a delimitation commission, who has already gone into this entire exercise of for the entire country, then there is no reason why you should withhold the implementation of a delimitation exercise which had happened in that interregnum of 2000 to 2002.
Okay.
So that's how the 2008 judgment came, and that is how post-2008 the elections were held on the basis of the Delimitation Commission recommendations of 2002. So that's the in-between period which was decided by the Supreme Court to be implemented.
Right. Thank you so much for that. Thank you for clarifying that. So, you know, and I just wanted to let our viewers also know, you know, these few constituencies which were in result of that delimitation exercise that happened in 2008 gave us Ghaziabad, Ambedkar Nagar, Fatehpur Sikri, Gautam Budh Nagar in Uttar Pradesh, also gave us Anandpur Sahib and Fatehgarh Sahib in Punjab, gave us a constituency like Bangalore Central and Bangalore Rural. All of this came up as a result of the 2008 delimitation exercise. Now, let me go across to our political panelists, and I'm going to start with Rajiv Pandey. Mr. Pandey, here is a legal view that says that even if the governor does it, it won't, be applicable for longer than 2 years. What is your party's stand on this? Should there be delimitation today in Jammu and Kashmir? And if why just Jammu and Kashmir, what about the rest of India?
I agree. Any ordinance, you have to make the law within 6 months and ordinance lapse within 6 months. Same way, this will be only for 2 years, but the Jammu Kashmir Vidhan Sabha can extend it to or can implement that. The issue is why it is required. The party has taken a stand at several times that this freezing of delimitation is against the interest of Jammu and Ladakh, and it should be done on the basis of population basis. We all know that Jammu is having higher population. Ladakh is having higher area, more than 60%. There per MLA constituency, it is around 80,000. However, in the Kashmir Valley, it is around 68,000 voters per constituency. So as far as that is concerned, that Jammu and Ladakh is being underrepresented in the Vidhan Sabha of Jammu and Kashmir Vidhan Sabha. So on that point, it is very much required that it should be done. As far as your one question, which I think Vikas Singh ji forget to reply, that if today that governor does this or government does this, whether they have to take permission from the Honorable Supreme Court of India or not, in my opinion, the amendment has been upheld. But if today it is being changed, I don't think that the governor or the government has to take first permission of the Honorable Supreme Court of India and then start this process.
Okay.
In my view, it can be started the process, and if somebody finds this difficult, they can approach the court, and then this whole process can be examined by the courts of law.
Okay, Dr. Sameer Kohl, come in here at this point of time, because BJP says it should be done. There is underrepresentation of the entire Jammu region in our assembly. Why is the National Conference then opposed to it?
Well, I mean, we are all aware that, you know, the legal counsel, the gentleman from the law and everyone else explained the legal consequences of why it was done and why we are doing it. And the Indian law provides that every 10 years there should be a delimitation process to make sure that people don't go underrepresented in a democratic country. Now, having said that, unless, of course, the parliament in its considered opinion decides otherwise. The last one done with the government of India, and we just followed a suit after they fixed the limit of 2026, and the delimitation would happen in 2031, was done. Now, singling out Jammu and Kashmir state at this point of time is completely in consonance with the BJP's political policy of give the dog a bad name and kill it, which is to take Kashmir and put it next to Pakistan, single them out and say that, and try and rouse opinion across this country against them and be belligerent about it and try to push through all laws that will result in an undue political victory or larger representation of their constituents in the coming assembly elections, which are scheduled for the end of the year, if they do it, which we are not even sure, they might even push it further. The question is that it is done in bad faith, it is morally wrong, it is not in accordance with usual, normal law of the country. It's
so
singling people
let me put it this way.
And really putting them into a disadvantage and pushing them against the wall.
Dr. Samiko, let me put it this way. Is your opposition only to the fact that it's being done for Jammu and Kashmir and not for the rest of the country? If the BJP had said, well, let's do it for everyone, would you then back it?
Well, what I would then say is that if you have enough reasons to hurry and you feel there is gross underrepresentation of deserving constituents across this country and we are part of this country, why not?
Okay.
But that isn't unfortunately the case. This is done just in consonance with a hyper-aggressive policy against the people of Jammu and Kashmir.
Okay, Dr. Harbhaksh Singh, quickly getting in a view from the PDP as well. Where does your party stand? Is it the right time? Because as even if a part of this country saw delimitation in 2008, in Jammu and Kashmir, it's not happened since 1995. Obviously, the demographics have changed. Obviously, there are some regions which are underrepresented. Why not fix that?
Tanvi, this is not the right time to do these things and exercises. When you are talking about the assembly elections, we have to wait for the legislature, and there is a census of 2011 that 55 lakh population is in Kashmir, 45 lakh population is in Jammu, and 2.5 lakh population is Ladakh. The census tells that there is a huge gap of population between Jammu and Kashmir. So this is not the time. I don't know why they are in such a hurry to do the things under the governor rule. And one more important thing, it is not the governor rule this time. We are in the president rule, and governor don't have the powers to do any amendment to the constitution. This is a constitutional right of the legislator to do changes, if any possible. And we have to wait it for the next census, 2011, and then 2031.
No, but we've already clarified the governor does have the power.
Why the center government and the governor is...
No, we've already clarified, the legal experts here have clarified, the exactly. governor does he have does, the power. He does have the power.
He didn't have the power.
No, he does. That's what I'm saying.
No.
It obviously has to be ratified by an assembly when it comes in.
Governor don't have the powers. It is the president rule this time.
Okay. So who has the power?
Yes,
when it's
it is the legislator
rule?
Only. And legislator can revoke the powers.
Tanviji, can I say just one line?
Yes. Okay. Mr. Rajiv Pandey can respond to this.
No, you see, this is a very political issue, because last time when this delimitation was done in 1993, and thereafter they have not done. You know, the reason behind is this, that there are 2-3 families in the Kashmir Valley who is trying to control whole Jammu and Kashmir. You know, if today delimitation has to be done, it will be done on the basis of prorata population and the area. What is the problem in that? Why you are trying to deprive the people of Jammu and Ladakh? It will be prorata the population and the area. So it is not going to affect. If you are saying that Kashmir Valley has more number of people, then it is not going to affect. Then what is, why this is a position? A position is only on one count. There are 2-3 families like Mufti family, Abdullah family, and two more families who are supporting terror and all. They want Jammu and Kashmir in their pocket. You know, that's why 47 seats and 37 seats, 46 seats and 37 seats, and only 4 seats to Ladakh. Why in 2002 law was amended that it should be freezed? The issue is only one. After 1993, there is no delimitation in Jammu and Kashmir. And the people are suffering. And if you are saying about the numbers, which what I said earlier, then it will be done on the basis of population and area. So okay. Why you are opposing this, sir?
Yes, Dr. Harbakh Singh, your response, and then we'll go to Samir Kaul.
Why we are not waiting for the next census and let us see how much population, and why they are in hurry to for delimitation only in Jammu and Kashmir? Why not in all over the India?
You are not replying.
What is the
my
problem?
Question. I'm sorry.
They have to create the fuss and all the instability in the Kashmir. They don't want the popular education, popular government in the Kashmir. You
there
see
will be
the
no instability. Don't worry about that, sir.
Today's notification.
Gone are the days.
Election
there will be no instability.
Mr. Pandey, one after each other. Please, let's not talk over each other.
This is only delay tactics. This is only befooling.
Yes. Dr. Harbakh, complete your point.
Tanvi ji, this is only tactics to divert the basic issues of Jammu and Kashmir. Basic amenities and Jammu and Kashmir.
How is this a tactic to better representation,
to delay the assembly
and
election?
Updated representation of the people living in Jammu
you
and
see,
Kashmir, whether it's
see,
in Jammu region
the,
or
today,
even in Kashmir region,
Tanvi,
whether it's the SCST or the other categories of people, why should they not get an apt representation Tanvi, in the assembly? I'm only trying to understand that.
Tanvi ji, you see, there is a popular government and there is power to legislator to do these things. Why governor and president will do that?
If okay,
there is,
let me bring in.
There is time to have proper time of assembly elections. They are trying to.
Okay, let me bring in.
Just say one line, Tanvi.
No, 1 minute,
can
1 minute.
Just say one line.
1 minute. Let me bring in Dr. Samir Kaul, because he
you
too
know,
asked this question. Why should you do it for?
One line I want to say.
Okay, what is your one line?
One line is, he is today saying that why governor should do this. First, Article 35, capital A, is not brought by the parliament, it is brought by the presidential order. First, he should ask PDP and National Conference that 35 capital A article of Indian Constitution should be removed because it was not brought through parliament, it was brought through presidential order. So that presidential order is good for PDP and National Conference, but this governor order will be wrong. What is this? Why is this double standard? If you are saying that presidential order or governor order is not good, then first you say that remove Article 35 capital A, which was not brought through parliament, it was brought through presidential order in 1954.
Okay, I want to bring in Dr. Call in here. Dr. Call, the fact of the matter is the difference in actual demographics between Jammu and Kashmir and Ladakh, also within Kashmir between various communities, experts say, is not reflected in the seat representation. That's not really true for rest of the country right now because we are significantly updated that in 2008. So then is it right for you to say why just single out Jammu and Kashmir and not the rest of the country?
No, I thought that singling out Jammu and Kashmir when there is going to be a census in 2026, and you have already got a schedule, singling it out at this point of time, after a general election, which has been fought on the rhetoric against Jammu and Kashmir and its people, more particularly the Kashmir Valley, and which is reflected in the various statements of the political parties on your program also tonight, where it's about families, it's about this thing. Well, you know, when we go to town about families, you conveniently forget that a majority of the ruling party people who won in this election have been products of families just belonging to one political party, the BJP. So just using these things very loosely against constituents of this country, we go to town, we go to the rest of the world and say that Jammu and Kashmir is a thriving democracy within the Indian Union. And I don't understand why, for some, what reason, is it for some petty political gains of trying to get more representation in the legislature that you resort to, you debunk all that work that has been done diplomatically across this world just to get more proportional, more MLAs of the BJP into the legislature? Why resort to provisional means when there is a properly laid out rule and a legal framework and a parliamentary framework across this country?
Okay.
I think it is wrong. If you ask me personally, and that is not my party's viewpoint.
Yes.
Last point, not my party's viewpoint, but it is my viewpoint that I don't think they want to do this delimitation as much as they made the Ram temple. They're just testing waters for the 35A and 370.
Okay. They're testing waters for sure. What will be their final policy? If there is a change, we will have to wait and watch.
But
Vinay, do you want to come in on what otherwise Dr. Call is saying on this argument of why single out one state?
Well, look, the trouble in this case, Tanvi, is that the singling out argument becomes valid or invalid depending on how far back you go. I mean, if you go far enough, then the argument can be reversed and say that, okay, this was Jammu and Kashmir which was singled out for not going in for a delimitation while the rest of the country was. So it depends on what's the cutoff period that you use. The fact of the matter, that's one. The other problem is, in Kashmir, facts and perceptions vary. And politics is also being played not just necessarily just on facts, but also on perception. The BJP is a very clever, intelligent party. They know. It's not as if they don't know that this issue will create a bit of a problem. The valley will be up in arms. There will be a bit of a boil on this issue. They know that very well. But remember, a lot of the Kashmir initiatives that the government is taking are not just meant for Kashmir. They're also meant for the rest of the country. There is a message that the party wants to send. Kashmir has been a very important focal point of the BJP, and they want to keep that pot boiling. 35A, 370 were always on the agenda. They've added this new thing into it simply because it allows the pot to get boiling. Even if the governor, for instance, does remove that proviso in the constitution that some people are saying, if you delete the paragraph, it becomes valid, it will definitely get challenged in a court of law. This is not something that's going to happen overnight in any case.
Correct.
But it still allows the point to be made. It allows the pot to be kept boiling. That is one. The other point I wanted to make, and Vikas is the legal expert here, he'll probably correct me if I'm wrong, but my understanding of the law was
that if the government of India sets up another delimitation commission and the delimitation commission submits a report, that cannot be challenged in a court of law. It's bound. You can't alter the proviso of a delimitation commission and you cannot challenge it in a court. Now, that's something that they can still do. I mean, that's my understanding. I could be wrong, but that's where I feel the constitution is.
Mr. Singh, do you want to come here? Because saying that if there is a delimitation commission which carries out a certain amount
well,
of work, yes, what happens then?
No, I don't agree that it can't be challenged. It definitely can be challenged. The point that I made earlier also, and I would like to emphasize a little bit on that, is the timing of the decision to do away with the proviso which froze that, which brought in that 2026. Actually, it's not 2026, it's the census which comes after 2026, it's actually 2031.
Okay.
So the freezing that has taken place all India is still 2031. Now, if the legislature in the Jammu and Kashmir were to do it using its plenary power, there would have been no problem because the legislature can always say that we are, you know, different from the rest of the country for X, Y, Z reason. But the governor exercising this extraordinary power and saying that during this interregnum when the legislature is not in CSN and the president's rule has been imposed, to amend the law in this manner when you know that you can't amend it permanently. Hmm. Because if the delimitation were to take place, and if the election were to take place, the elected body would remain for 5 years. Whereas this amendment which the governor proposes to do or remove this proviso, this removal can only take place for 2 years. So just imagine a situation where the next election were to be held, say, sometime in, today we are in 19, so 24. And in the next election, 24, if the legislature is already in place and if the legislature doesn't ratify the decision of the governor, then this 2026 freeze will again come in. So again, the constituencies will have to go back to the pre-2019 situation and the assemblies will remain like that. So the point that I'm making is that it is not justified at this point of time to suddenly start this exercise when in the entire country you are not, because the changes that have happened in the entire country have happened in Jammu and Kashmir as well. So it's not that it has not happened in Telangana or not happened in Andhra Pradesh or in Tamil Nadu. So everywhere this change has happened, demographic change has happened. But that demographic change is frozen to 2001 today because of the intervention of the Supreme Court. Otherwise it was 76
okay.
or rather 71. So now that the 2001 freezing is continuing for the rest of the country, there is no justification to single out Jammu and Kashmir when another state can say that or somebody who files a petition in Jammu and Kashmir want to challenge and say that this change has happened all over the country. So if the change of demography has happened all over the country, why single out Jammu and Kashmir and suddenly do this exercise now,
okay.
especially when the president's rule? Assembly taking that call would have been very different from the governor taking that call today. That's my point.
Okay, let me go across to Mr. Rahul Jalali. Do you agree with that? And my point is that if you look at the representation in the assembly, specifically Jammu and Kashmir assembly, do you actually foresee a situation where such a delimitation proposal will be cleared by the assembly?
No, I don't. Firstly, let me also point out to everyone that the assembly doesn't exist in Jammu and Kashmir. It's on long leave and it does not hold any sittings. It doesn't exist. So that's point number one. So when you talk about assembly ratifying delimitation...
No, it's not on long leave. It is completely...
I think you've got to look at it closely because there is no assembly, you see.
Yes.
So that you've got to take into account. Secondly, when you talk of delimitation, now delimitation, knowing Kashmir and pretty well at that, delimitation somehow is like a red rag to the bull in Kashmir. Somehow that the sound upsets them, for whatever the reasons might be. So when you take up this issue of delimitation, you've got to keep Kashmir in mind. Jammu and Ladakh might go along with this entire issue, but I have my doubts about Kashmir. Now, Kashmir today, this is the point I had made earlier, is fairly calm. So do you want to upset the apple cart again? Do you want Kashmir to again go up in problems which you've had over the years? So I think that is the moot question.
But
do you want to unbalance Kashmir? I think that needs to be kept in mind before you go into any such measures of delimitation. I think a better exercise would be to involve the people of Jammu and Kashmir, do an informal sort of check, if it might be, about what would be the mood for delimitation among Kashmiris and among people from Jammu and Ladakh, if such a thing is held. I think you've got to prepare a ground for delimitation in the valley as well as elsewhere before you go ahead with delimitation. I think that is a possibility which can be explored.
But Mr. Jalali,
no one is doing that.
Mr. Jalali, you say that right now things are relatively peaceful there, calm there. Why you know, change that? But if we don't look at the option of doing it now when things are peaceful, we certainly can't be looking at it when things are tensed and there is a lot of militancy or anti-India sentiment which is on the streets there.
Well, I'm not talking of anti-India sentiments right now, but the fact is, this is precisely what I'm saying. Why do you want to upset the apple cart? Mm. Why do you want to disturb Kashmir? It's not a question of doing it when things are peaceful. You are going to affect that peace. Do you want it? That's the issue. Secondly, see, when it comes to delimitation,
well, that's a political...
who's it going to benefit? What difference is it going to make? You know, this is a crucial question which every person from Jammu and Kashmir would be throwing at you.
Correct.
So who's it going to benefit? And these are questions which are going to be raised moment you go in for delimitation. I'm not talking of the legalese part of it. I'm talking of the political ramifications of delimitation. And look, everything in Kashmir is politics. Let's forget the rest. I mean, if legally things would have worked out in Kashmir, Kashmir would have been a different story altogether.
Right.
But that's not the case.
Okay,
Things are very different. So do you want to give a handle to these people yet again?
Who would benefit?
That's my issue.
Who would benefit from this exercise? Who would benefit from delimitation in Kashmir today? Rajiv Pandey. Everybody assumes it's the BJP.
Tanviji, this kind of talks that we have to talk, we have to do the groundwork, we have to talk to them. You know, all people of Jammu and Kashmir and all people of the country are having the same rights. Not the people who are from Kashmir Valley, they are having bigger rights than the people of Ladakh or Jammu. These kind of things have only created this Kashmir issue. Now Kashmir is calm because the government has taken action.
No, Mr.
That's
Pandey,
why it is calm. All
about?
The terror funders are now lying in Tihar. And today also three terror funders have come to Tihar now in Delhi. So, you know, calm it is because of the action taken by the Jammu Kashmir police, CRPF, army, central government, state government. So whatever action, whatever is the law is required, it has to be implemented. It cannot be said that first we have to talk, then we have to create the environment. We have seen this 70 years environment. Environment is very good. Whatever is as per law, that should be done. If governor has power, they will do it. And tomorrow you can question. You can question if it is not as per law, it will be a strike down. If it is as per law, you have to go ahead and deal with as per law. And people, you ask one more question, who will be benefited? The people of Jammu Kashmir will be benefited because the equal representation to all. Value of the votes will be equal to all people of Jammu and Kashmir, whether he's from Jammu, whether he's from Ladakh, or whether he is from Kashmir Valley.
Okay.
Everybody will have equal weightage of their vote.
Okay, well, you say as if it's going to happen tomorrow, but I don't think it's going to happen that soon. It's a very long and elaborate process. Even when you initiated, you set up a commission. The commission will then put out a gazetted notification, ask for people to respond on it, do their own surveys and research, refer to the census. There will then be a big debate on which census, because right now we only have 2011. So do we wait for the next one or do it right away? Then it will again have to be published, implemented. It's a long process at this point of time, and obviously there will be a big debate. It just seems right now, though, the government is only testing waters of what the sentiment is out there before they actually start doing anything seriously. I'm going to thank all of our panelists for joining us. It's been an insightful conversation and not a loud rhetorical one about what really needs to be done. But what does it really mean? It means a more apt and appropriate and a better representation of people from various castes and communities. Because remember, if the census is used as your benchmark, then even the representation for SC/ST communities, even the seats that are designated as SC/ST seats, could actually change because the demographics have changed. Better representation for people from Jammu and Kashmir and Ladakh, depending on the population there, so that the lawmakers can then come together and take decisions that are in their best interest. It is perhaps something that we can sit and look at, and politicians really have to see this as something which is good for the entire state and not something for their own petty politics to just keep the pot boiling in the state of Jammu and Kashmir. At the end of the day, we need to step back and think that the politicians are actually helping the people of Jammu and Kashmir or simply adding fuel to fire on a daily basis just so that they keep on getting votes. Something to think about. The point here is that the Election Commission has decided mostly the state polls will be held this year at an opportune time after the Amarnath Yatra ends, perhaps in the last quarter of this year. We'll keep a close eye on the state elections and, of course, if the government decides to take this consideration any forward. Thank you so much for joining us on this big debate.